Hello students, how are you all? Today we are going to start the graphical representation of data. In our last video in statistics, we already learned about that how to arrange all the data. In this part, we will learn that how to represent all those data in a given bar graph, pie chart, and as well as we will analyze all those given bar graphs. First of all, let me give you the idea about the bar graph. What is that? For doing any kind of bar graph, you need to draw two axes, that is along x-axis and y-axis. According to Cartesian coordinate, these are the following axes, and along that you can represent your data. Suppose, very simply I'm telling you that there are three students, say Raj, Rahul and Rakib, and Raj have some topics, say three topics. Okay, so I'm drawing a bar as you can see over here, and the bar is up to three. So we are measuring from here 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and so on. Now about Rahul, Rahul has 5 topics, so the bar will move up to 5. Similarly, coming to Rakib, Rakib has 6 topics, so the bar will come up to 6. So this is how we have to do the bar graph, very simple. Now, if you want to convert this given bar graph into histogram, then what you have to do? You have to connect all the top midpoints of this given bar. So first of all, give the point as I am doing over here, then just join them. So now your histogram is ready. You can also remain your histogram with this bar graph, or if you want, you can delete all those or erase all those lines. But my recommendation is that you should remain in this paper with the bar graph. Okay. So that is all about histogram. So let me start with the first one. In first one, you can see over here, let me zoom it, wait a minute. Let me zoom it very clearly because we can see it very clear over here. Okay, so one histogram is given. About what? About some monthly crime record. Okay, so in monthly crime record, we can see that 6 months are there, January to June. Okay, so in January, the pointer, that is the top point of the bar, if you notice one thing, if you have any bar over here, or you can draw any bar over here, that will look like this. So they are emitting the bar for this case, so we don't want actually over here. Okay, so first of all, crime recorded for January is 15. Now see that, after 1 month, that in February, that the crime is increases. So this is showing the increase of crime by that length. Now in March, the crime again decreases, and now the value is 20. Again in April, the crime increases in its maximum, so it is 45 right now. And in next month, May, crime decreases, it is 30 right now. And finally in June, the crime again increases a little, that is 35. So all over, the crime increases in 6 months, as you can see, finally. So that is the histogram, and that is how we are analyzing all the records from this graph. Okay, so let me answer all those given questions one by one. In this case, first of all, the month in which the maximum number of crime was recorded, that is simply you can see that the April with 45 crimes. Coming to the next one, the month in which the minimum crime recorded, you can see that is January with 15 crime. So your answer will be January. After that, the month when same number of crime was recorded. So lastly, we have seen that it is 35 June, and this is also 35 in February. So these are the 2 months that having same number of crimes. Finally, Coming to the last question, the number of crimes recorded between the first 2 months, that is the number of crime recorded between the first 2 months, if you notice one thing, that is the second and that is the first. So what should be the between them? That is, it's increasing from 15 to 35. So how much increases? If you subtract from 35 to 15, you will get that it is 20 crime increases during these 2 months. So that is how you have to analyze all the given histogram, and after that you have to perform the sum. Okay, now moving to how we can draw this given pie chart and given bar graph. Let me first come with this bar graph, after that I will move to the pie chart. So I am doing number 6 in this case first, and as you can see over here, Janak's earning in the first 5 months of year is given as this. So these are the earnings given for each of the months, and we have to draw a line bar graph for this kind of data. So what our first work, that is draw the axes and mark them. I'm just telling you step by step, please follow all this. And after that it is x-axis and that is y-axis. So while you get that x and y-axis, you have to denote which one is representing what. So this one representing the months, and this one representing the amount. You can also write money, but amount will look nice over here in rupees. If you're using some value or unit, you must write it in the name. Okay, so after that, first one January. So we will write total January, as we don't have any space over here, we are only writing J. Okay, but you have to write whole word. So January, and before that we have to check which one is the lowest and which one is the highest value. So as we can see over here, 19,000 is the highest value. So we will take that graph scale up to 20,000, more than that highest value. So we will start always from 0. Then this one is 10,000. This one 10,000. This one 11. And this is how we will reach up to 20,000. So 11, 12, 13. 14, and suppose we need more space over here. Wait a minute, let me erase all that thing. And first of all, we have to mark it with 15k. That is the middle one, very easier to us right now to bring the values. So it will be 11, 12, 13, 14, and that will be 16, 17, 18, 19. Very easy. You can also write all those values, or you can do this kind of mark as well, but mark is compulsory. Okay, with same separation. Coming to January, what is your earning? Sorry, what is Janak's earning? That is 15,000, right? So we need to draw a bar graph. Let me do it with another color. It will be up to 15,000. Okay, so you have to draw a proper graph. In here, my diagram is not proper, so I am writing particular rectangle over here. So right now it is proper. You can see we have 15k, up to 15k, one bar for January. Coming to February, I am writing F. I am telling you again, I am just writing the first letter. You have to write the total word in this particular spaces. After that, how much is the earning for February? That is 12,000. So this is 10, 11, and this is 12. So we have to draw up to this. Coming to the next one, that is March. That is 18,000. So we have to reach a little bit high over here. This is 18. So we have to draw it from here. Okay. After that, that is April and 19,000. So April, 19,000. So we have to reach at the last final mark. It is not the final, we have 20, but still the previous one of 20. So we have to start it from here. Finally, the May, that is with 12,000. Again, we have the same value, 12,000. It will be here. So let me draw another one from here. So all we have right now the bar graphs from here. If we supposed to draw the line graph, which is known as histogram, then what we have to do? We have to connect all the given top middle point of this bar graph one by one. So let me do it. First of all, your work should be mark the middle point, as I am doing over here. After that, just take simple line and connect them one by one. So as you can see, I am connecting all those dots. So finally, my histogram is completed. And after that, if you want to remain with that bar graph, you can. Otherwise, you can remove all that bar graph, so you will have that line graph. So I hope the idea is clear about bar graph and line graph, and both are known as histogram. Okay, coming to pie chart right now. What is pie chart? Similarly, as we explained all that thing in bar graph or linear graph, we can also explain the same thing in a pie chart. Very simply, I'm telling you, suppose you have a pizza and four students are there, or you have four friends with you. So how much will each of them get? That is obviously quarter of that pizza. You have to slice it in four parts. Now you all know about the angles. So just tell me which one should be each angle, that is completely 90 degrees. So the percentage, that is 1 by 4 part, is represented as for this circle is 90 degree. I hope the idea is clear. Now if one of your friend eat half of that pizza, then, and also there are two friend extra, so total is 3 right now. One, it's totally half of that, so right now it is 180, right? So half represented as 180. And rest of the pizza is divided into two other friends. So that is 90 and 90, which is 1 by 4. So this is how we are dividing all the values in a pie chart. This is known as pie chart. So let me show you how we will draw the pie chart for different kind of arbitrary values. Okay, so first one, let me erase all this thing. I am taking one complete perfect circle. You have to draw pie chart. Remember that you have to draw pie chart in white paper, but for bar graph you have to use graph paper. So during exam, keep the graph paper with you. That is compulsory. So in number 5, we have the UP government decide to revise the public expenditure in all these parts, that is industry, agriculture, education, transport, power and housing. So in all these parts, the all value means the total money that government is giving, and the percentage of these are going to each of these given conditions. Okay, so for the first one, in industry they are using 30% of money. 30% of what? As we can see, it is up to 100. That means we are taking the percentage among 100, right? So in 100 we are taking 30. So if I told you the amount, you will easily find that what percent of that amount we are actually giving in industry. So this is the idea. But how can we convert that into degree? That is the first question. For that, you need a simple formula. That is theta, which is angle, is equal to, you also can write over here angle. Angle theta, that is equal to V by S into 360. Now what is that? V is the value. Value means how much you are giving. S is the sum. That is sum. That means the total value. Now, after dividing all that, you have to multiply with 360. That is the simple formula for this case. Now, what you have to do? As you can see over here, theta equal to value by sum into 360, right? So, all you have to do over here, that theta is the angle. All you need value by sum. In here, that value by sum is given to you as percentage. So the value will be 25 and the sum will be 100, because you are giving 25% out of 100. I am just telling for 25%. And in here, in this sum, it is first for the industry given as 30%. So what should be the output?
That is 30 out of 100. 30 will be the value, sum will be the 100. And that should be multiplied with 360. As you can see, 0 and 0 are cancelling. So 36 into 3. So it will be 108. So the degree value right now we have 108 degree. So all you have, first of all, put the center over there, then put your compass. So all you have your point, that is the center of the circle. Now put your protractor over here, that will give you the mark of the 108 degree. So you will actually measure from here that what should be the value of or the mark of 108 degree. Just draw 108 degree from there. Again, remove your protractor from there. After that, you will get a line from this point, mark point, to the center, then join it with the base. So you got 108 degree. Now that is for the first case. What about the second one? Second one is given as agriculture. Agriculture means 20% is given. So 20%, how can we do that? Let me show you. Instead of 30 over here, now we have to put 20, right? So it will be 20, and then it will be multiplied with 36. 2 into 36, it will be 72. All we have over here, that is 72 degree right now. So in this case, 72 degree. But whenever this time you will put your protractor, you have to put it like that. As you can see, the protractor base is aligned with this line, and the center of the protractor is at the center of the circle always. So after placing the protractor with this, when you will happy with your position of protractor, then you have to measure the 72 degree. That is maybe somewhere over here. So just put a line over here from here to here. Then remove your protractor and just join that line or continue that line up to the O point or the center of that circle. Then mark this one as 72 degree. So by continuation of this process, you will get the whole pie chart. And one more thing I like to notice over here, whenever you will take any region, don't forget to write the name of that particular subject or particular thing that you are representing by that region. So as we are representing industry by that region of 108 degree, so we will write industry. And for the second region, we need agriculture. So as you can see, if you take a very small circle, it will be very difficult to write all the names. So I will suggest you to take a big circle, not very big, but a decent size. That will help you to give proper notation with proper words. So that is all for the pie chart. I hope you have the idea about the pie chart. Also, you can analyze the pie chart by this. And that is all about the data handling. And still, if you have any doubt, don't forget to write it in the comment section. Also, you can ask me in the group. I will surely help you. So thank you for today.